Next talk will be given by Dr. Wei Chen from Guangdong University of Technology, and she has been doing cultural discovery for quite some years, and she has done very good work in how to discover latent values.
Okay, thanks for the introduction and thanks to the invitation and organizer. And good afternoon. I'm Wei Chen. Today I will give a talk about color discovery with latent variables based on high-order qubits. And this work was collaborated with Zhui Chucai, Kun Zhang, and Clark Limer, Shifeng Hao, and Zhiyi Huang. So I will give a brief introduction about the color model with latent variables, and then I will show how to do color discovery based on high-order qubits. So as we know, I would like to discuss the causation is not equal to the association because the causation indicates how the world progresses. Let us see this example. We can see that if you do some data mining from the data, we may find that the yellow teeth is directly proportional proportionally with the lung cancer. But as we know, whitening the teeth cannot cure cancer because there is a common cause smoking behind them. So if we consider the causation, we can know that the smoking can cause the yellow teeth and the smoking can cause the lung cancer, but there is no correlation between yellow teeth and lung cancer. So how do we recover these correlations? The gold standard is randomized controlled trial. But as previous speakers had mentioned, RCT is costly and essential and invisible. Thus, we focus on color discovery only from partially observed data. So we try to find some color discovery algorithm to infer color relationships among variables from partially observed data. What is partially observed data? That means that some data implied observed latent variables. So the latent variable that we are interested is latent confounder. The confounder is not influenced by observed variables, and it is a common cause of at least two observed variables. So the latent confounder is that the confounder is unmeasured or unobserved. In the previous example, the smoking is the latent confounder for yellow teeth and lung cancer. So the open problem to solve this pro di so to solve this task is how to detect latent confounders and identify the underlying color structure among latent confounders and observed variables from partially observed data. So to solve these problems, the basic assumption is the color Markov assumption and the color faithfulness assumption. The constraint-based method utilized the conditional independent test to solve this problem, but it remained Markov equivalent classes. So some people are trying to use functional-based method to solve the problem. This kind of method consider the data generating process. In linear non-Gaussian case, assume the data generated by this way and by this way, and this function is corresponding to the x is the cos of y. So we can see from these figures, in the Gaussian case, in both directions, if you regress one variable on another variable, the residual is independent. It is independent of the assumed cause. But if in the uniform case, in the true color directions, the residual is independent of the assumed cause. But in the false directions, the residual is dependent on the assumed cause. So we can find a symmetry criterion to determine the color directions between two observed variables. And this condition we denote as independent noise condition. So this way can only to use in used to color discovery without latent variables. But so how to, if there is it latent variables, how can we solve the color discovery problem? And based on the previous model, based on the Lingang model, so some research have proposed a typical model named latent variable Lingang. Lingang means linear non-Gaussian acyclic model. So this model can be formalized as this way. X is the observed variable, and L is the latent variables. E is the noise term. B and lambda are two matches denote the color strengths. So the typical method to latent variable Lingang is the overcomplete ICA model. The research will translate this model into the overcomplete ICA model as this. So they aim to analyze the missing metric. But the overcomplete ICA method is unreliable because it is easy to fall into local optimal, and it has no closed form solution, although it has a certain accuracy when the number of other variables is small. So we try to find other techniques to capture more information from data. Before I introduce the method, let me introduce the high order cumulants. The cumulants of a random vector Z can be defined as this way. And it has two important properties, the linearity and the independence. If any of the random variables is statistically independent, then the joint cumulants is zero. So we can use these two important properties to do color discovery. First, we propose a closed form solution to overcomplete ICA in a specific case. And we consider the one latent component structure. What is the one latent component structure? It is, this graph can be an example. That means two or three variables share one latent component in L, and the generating process can be formalized as a latent variable Lingang model as this way. And so we can attain the joint cumulants, the second order and the third order cumulants of X and Y as these three equations. Interestingly, we can find that the third order cumulants can share only one terms about the third order cumulants of latent variables. So we can attempt the closed form solution to estimate the color effect from latent variable to the observed variable as this way. But I need to mention that in this case, we know the color graph is the one latent component structure, but in color discovery problem, we didn't know the color graph and we aim to recover the color graph. So how to solve this problem? A straightforward idea may be following this, and we can assume for each true variable, for each true variable, we can assume that they satisfy one latent component structure, and then we estimate the choral effect from latent variable to observable, and we can attain the residual about the two observable. Then we test whether that residual is independent. If two residual is independent, we can accept the hypothesized structure. Otherwise, we reject it. So this testable framework, we can use this testable framework to identify the latent confounder and determine the choral durations between two observable. How do we do this? So we can randomly choose three observable, and then we try to test with in this form whether they satisfy one latent component condition. If they satisfy the one latent component condition, that means that there is a shared latent variable behind them. That means they satisfy the one latent component structure. So in this way, we can identify which variables that share the same latent confounder. The second problem is how to determine the choral orders. We can see the right hand side in this graph. If two variables are not affected by the latent variable, and one variable is the cause of the other. So we can see that the noise term of the cause is influence the two observed variable. So in this way, we can see that S1 is the shared latent component for X1 and X2. So we can use X1 as a surrogate variable to test whether X1 and X1, X2 satisfy one latent component condition. If it is satisfied, then we can conclude that there is a direct edge between X1 and X2, and X1 is the cause of the X2. Oh, sorry. Here, X1 is the choral earlier than X2. Until now, what we discussed is the one latent component structure. If two observed variables are shared multiple latent components, how do we solve this problem? One may think that if we can remove the shared identified latent components, then we can try to find whether there is it a new one latent component structure. So this is our idea. We try to make it possible to have only a one latent component structure and perform this way iteratively. So let us see this running example. In the beginning, we will begin with a complete undirected graph and then identify the latent variable by the one latent component condition. And then we try to remove the effect from the identified latent confounder. In this example, we can find that first we will identify the L1. L1 is the shared latent component for X1 X2, X4. So we can remove the effect from X1 to this three variable, and then we can identify the other latent variables. After we identify all the latent variable, or we didn't find any one latent component, any variable that satisfy one latent component structure, we can determine the color order between two other variables. And this process will be conducted iteratively until no more one latent component condition is found. So because there is no most of the existing methods cannot solve this problem, so our method can outperform existing methods. Until now, we can see that the one latent component condition requires additional and specific other variable. So if there are only two observables, can we distinguish the color structure in behind only two observables? So we just think, can we still make use high order cumulants? We can see that these three color structure can be classified into two class. The one is there is no direct edge between two observable, and the other is there is an edge between two observable, but we need to distinguish the color durations between two observable. So let us consider the first case. There is no direct edge between two observable, and two observable are affected by a single latent variable. So we can write out the fourth order joint cumulants of X1 and X2 as equation 1, 2, 3. Interestingly, we can see that these three equations share the only one terms, and this terms is about the fourth order cumulants of latent variable. So if we multiply this joint cumulants, we can attain this criterion. So this criterion can be used to test whether the edge between X1 and X2 exists. The second, if there is it a color edge between two observable, so how do we determine the color durations between them? So let us consider this case two. So if we write out the third order cumulants of X1 and X2 as these equations, we can see that they both share two terms that mark as red, and the third cumulants of X2 share the extra terms about the third order cumulants of its noise. So we can see the problem that can we estimate the share these two shared terms, and then we can test whether this equation is equal to zero. If we can recover these two terms, and the third order cumulants of X1 can be estimated from the data, so we can might use the distance to minus these two shared terms, then we can see that whether it is equal to zero to determine the color duration. Because in the both directions, the effect, the stimulant or the effect variable is will have a ascertance. So it this way, this criterion will not be zero. And this tool is identified, this tool is proved in the this tool theory, and the required parameters can be estimated by high order cumulants. So we can develop a learning algorithm as follows. First, we will identify whether there is a latent coral edge between two observed variables. Then, if there is a coral direct edge, so then we will identify the coral directions between two observed variables. And so the previous criterion only discussed about the two observed variables. So in the high dimension way, how can we recover the whole coral structure? The basic idea is that we can make use of the skeletal learning method and the previous conditions and provide a more efficient approach. So because the skeleton can be used to detect the latent confounders, and the condition can be used to learn the confounder, the structure among observed variables that are affected by the latent variable. So the running example is we first try to detect whether there is a shared latent confounder, and then we estimate the remaining undetermined local structure with some conditions. So we can see that under some mild assumptions, the coral structure can only learn from observed data even when there are latent confounders. And by resorting to non-Gaussianity and the high-order cumulants, the functional coral model-based method can identify more coral structures. And last but not least, I will introduce a Python code, a Python package coral learn. It is the implementation of up-to-date coral discovery methods as well as simple and intuitive APIs. And you can download it from GitHub and use it with a simple way. If you have any question, you can post issue in GitHub or send us an email. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Wei. So we have time for one quick question.
So you have sufficient conditions, not necessary conditions, right? So you mean you solve that question doesn't mean there are the latent factors. Because there are many, many equations could be implied to.
They are sufficient and necessary.
By that mean, so under the conditions, the specified conditions, then it's necessary and sufficient. However, the specified graphical conditions may be come too strong, meaning that the conditions are sufficient. If the condition holds true, then yes, here you can see the discovered structure. And we have a asymptotic correctness guarantee. But if the structure, the conditions, the actual condition could be weaker, that's why the condition may not be really necessary. Right?
Yeah,
cool. Thank you. Cool. Thank you, Wei. A very nice talk.